Good morning, students. Myself, Professor Phoola Rani, working in the Department of Agriculture, GGDSD College, Haryana, Hoshiarpur. The topic for my today's presentation is Ecological Sucession. Under this topic, we will learn the different types of ecological successions and their origin. The definition of ecological succession. Ecological succession is the process of change in the species structure of an ecological community over time. This time can be a decade or more than a decade. For example, after a wildfire, the species can occur within some months or even some years, or even millions of years after a mass extinction. The observed process of change in the species structure of an ecological community over a period of time is known as the ecological succession. Successions are of two types, primary succession and secondary succession. It is a phenomena or process by which an ecological community undergoes more or less orderly or predictable changes following a disturbance or the initial colonization of new habitat. Succession may be initiated either by formation of new unoccupied habitat, such as from a lava flow or a severe landslide, or by disturbance of a community, such as fire, logging, etc. The succession that begin in new habitat, uninfluenced by the pre-existing communities, is called primary succession, whereas succession that followed disturbance of a pre-existing community is called the secondary succession. French naturalist who gave the term succession was Adolphe Duru de Dalimale, was the first to make use of the word succession. So, an example of an area in which a community has never lived before would be a lava or rock from a volcano. Now, coming to the point from where these microflora get the nutrition in case of primary succession, because in primary succession there was no pre-existing community or the mode of nutrition in that particular place. Primary succession begins with the colonization of an area that has not been previously occupied by any ecological community, such as newly exposed rock or sand surface, lava, newly exposed glacial tills, etc. And the stages of primary succession include pioneer microorganisms, plants, grassy stage, small shrubs, trees, and all these provided by the lichens. When the lichens, they die, this is the lichens, they die, they decompose, adding small amount of organic matter to the rocks to make soil, and this soil containing the organic matter is used as a nutrients by the new type of plants, or you can say mosses, ferns can grow on these new soil. Now, after the rock have been converted into soil by the lichens, now the simple plants in the form of ferns and mosses, they have developed on the rock, and these small plantes or simple plants, they all started dying and again adding organic matter like the lichens. And these plants, when die, they add more nutrients to the soil. Now these more nutrients are further utilized by not only simple plants but also by the shrubs and trees, can survive on this soil, that is rock turned into the soil. In this slide you can see the systematic description of the primary succession. You can see along x-axis there are time, that is hundred of years. It can be some months, some decades, or million years also. For to make a primary community or succession, there are three stages. First is pioneer stage, second is intermediate stage, and on right hand side the climax community. In pioneer stage, first is the bare rock. Bare rock is converted into soil with the help of second stage is lichens. Lichens basically the association between the fungus and the algae. Algae are photosynthetic, they can prepare their food at their own, and fungus are non-photosynthetic. They absorb the food and give to the algae, or this is the symbiotic association in which both of them are mutually benefited from each other. These lichens small after dying give the nutrients or organic matter to the soil, and small annual plants started growing on this rock and along with the lichens. Then what will happen after passage of time, because more and more nutrients are adding organic in the form of organic matter by the dying of small annual plants, lichens, there is a perennial herbs or grasses. First herbs and grasses will start growing. And if, when there are herbs there, grasses there, the pioneer stage stops, and then is the stage of intermediate. In the intermediate stage, these grasses, shrubs also start the making of shade intolerant trees. So after the growth, you can see in the figure on the slide that there are three communities, not no small plants also and the large plant also. And after the passage of times, there is a full-fledged tree, you can say, or the shade tolerant trees are there. So this is known as the climax community. I'll discuss in detail what is the climax community. Climax community basically the definite community in a particular area. So this is the primary succession. In this slide, you can see the secondary succession. The slides are marked 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Please concentrate on the slide number 1. Number 1 is a stable deciduous forest community. Number 2, a disturbance such as wildfire destroy the forest. Number 3, the fire burns the forest to the ground. Number 4, the fire leaves behind empty but not destroyed soil. Number 5, grasses and other herbaceous plants grow back first. Number 6, small bush and trees begin to colonize the area. Number 7, fast growing evergreen trees develop to their fullest while shade tolerant trees develop in the understory. Number 8, short-lived and shade intolerant evergreen trees die as a large deciduous trees develop or overlap them. The ecosystem is now back to similar state to which it began. We can define secondary succession. Dynamics following severe disturbance or removal of a pre-existing community are called secondary succession. Dynamics in secondary succession are strongly influenced by pre-disturbance conditions, including soil development, seed banks, remaining organic matter, and residual living organisms. Because of residual fertility and pre-existing organisms, community changes in early stages of secondary succession. For example, Acadia National Park that have been fully destroyed by the wildfire now have been regenerated, and it is the exact example of secondary succession. Now, what is the reason behind the plant successions? Autogenic succession can be brought by change in the soil because by the organisms there. These changes include accumulation of organic matter in litter or humic layer, alteration of soil nutrients, change in the pH of soil due to the plant growing there. The structure of the plants themselves can also alter the community. For example, when larger species like trees mature, they produce shade onto the developing forest floor that tend to exclude light requiring species. Shade tolerant species will invade the area. The second cause behind the secondary succession is allogenic succession. Is caused by external environmental influence and not by the vegetation. For example, soil changes due to erosion, leaching, or the deposition of silt and clay can alter the nutritional content and water relationship in the ecosystem. Animals also play an important role in allogenic changes as they are pollinators and seed dispersers and herbivores. They can also increase nutrient content of the soil in certain areas or shift soil about, creating patches in the habitats. This may create regeneration sites that favor certain species. In 1916, Frederick Clements published a descriptive theory of succession known as classical ecological theory. According to Clements, succession is a process involving not only one phase but several phases. Number one, nudation. Succession begins with the development of a bare site called nudation, or you can say a disturbance also. Number two, migration. It is refers to the arrival of propagules. And number three is the axis. It involves the establishment, or you can say it is the initial growth of the vegetation. Number four, competition. After there is the growth of the vegetation, as vegetation becomes well established, grows and spread, various species begin to compete for space, light and nutrients. Now there is a competition, so this is a law of survival of the fitness. There is a reaction. During this phase, autogenic changes such as the buildup of humus affect the habitat and one plant community replaces the another. And last step is the stabilization. A stable climax community exists in the final stage. So students, in this presentation we have covered the different types of successions and their origin. For further query, please you can contact me at my mail ID foolarani@yahoo.co.in. Thank you.